Hi everyone, this is ENT student. Today I'm going to explain the topic National Programs of Prevention of Noise, Competency 2.15. Introduction. Noise is often defined as unwanted sound, but this definition is subjective because of the fact that one man's sound may be another man's noise. Sources. It has many sources such as automobiles, factories, industries, and aircrafts, etc. Properties. Noise has two properties, loudness and frequency. First, loudness. Loudness or intensity depends upon the amplitude of the vibrations which initiated the noise. Loudness of noise is measured in decibels, dB. A daily exposure of 85 decibels is about the limit people can tolerate without substantial damage to their hearing. Here we have a picture showing the recommended maximum and the various sound pressure levels in decibels, ranging from 160 to 10. Next is frequency. Frequency is denoted as hertz, HZ. 1 hertz is equal to 1 wave per second. The human ear can hear frequencies from about 20 to 20,000 hertz, but this range is reduced with age and other subjective factors. Vibrations which are below 20 hertz are called infra-audible, and those above 20,000 hertz are called ultrasonic. Next, we have the instruments which are used in the studies of noise. First one, the sound level meter, which measures the intensity of sound in decibels. Next, number two, we have the octave band frequency analyzer, which measures the noise in octave bands. Third, we have the audiometer, which measures the hearing ability. Next, we have the effects of noise exposure. So number one, we have auditory effects. This has 2 points, which are auditory fatigue and deafness. Next, we have non-auditory effects, which has the following: interference with speech, annoyance, efficiency, physiological change. Next, we have control of noise. So the first way is careful planning of cities. This is done by two methods: division of the city into zones, which separate the areas concerned with industries and transport. Next is separation of residential areas from the main streets by means of wide green belts. Green belts are strips of trees which help reduce sound. Next, we have control of vehicles. Heavy vehicles should not be routed into narrow streets. Vehicular traffic on residential streets should be reduced. Number three, to improve the acoustic insulation of building. This can be done by following the best arrangement, which is construction of detached buildings instead of a large single building. Next, number four, industries and railways. We have to move industries and railways away from the residential area. Number five, protection of exposed persons. Hearing protection is recommended for all workers who are consistently exposed to a noise louder than 85 decibels in the frequency bands above 150 hertz. Next, sixth point is legislation. And the seventh is education. Thank you, everyone.